into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Miami Marlins taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. First pitch coming your way next. About to get started here, and on the mound for Tampa Bay in this one, Jeffrey Springs. And thinking, we were talking earlier about how he's doing a great job navigating through tough spots.
I've just been so impressed with when it seems like there's more pressure, he's more calm and settles in. He's done an incredible job with runners in scoring position. Most guys, they get a little tight, they start to aim, but for some reason, he gets looser, the ball comes out of his hand with more life, and he's able to wiggle off the hook of tough situations and get his team back in the dugout.
Jazz Chisholm stands in now, looks at that one inside.
First hit, 640.
One, two. A foul ball, he stays alive. One and two now. That one ran inside, almost got him. Next offering way off the plate. And a pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Kicks and fires. And that's ball four.
And he reluctantly takes his walk.
Leading off. Gene Segura to play here.
The shortstop. Gene Segura.
And that's in there for strike one. Chisholm gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Next pitch inside, 2-1.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
The pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. Stays alive. Nobody out. Runner first. Got him. And there's one down.
Frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Here's Ramon Laureano. Moving first. Chisholm back on a dive. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
He's going.
Runner takes off. It's a pitch out. And he cuts it down. Great throw.
That goes to show you stealing base is a tough thing to do and far from a sure thing, even with big-time speed. It's not easy to catch him, but that was a great catch and throw. Quick, not rushed, and accurate.
pitches outside.
Well, they're really running up the pitch count in this first inning. Lots of confidence from this team that is perhaps the hottest in baseball right now.
And here it comes. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Yoan Moncada takes one off the outside here. Springs checks on first. Laureano dives back in safely. Next offering is in for a strike. At the belt and fires. Left field. Peralta gets under it. He's got it. And that is out number three. One left for Miami. And now the Rays will get their first opportunity to score this ballgame. You're dialed in to the show. Bottom of the first. And on the hill in this one, Edward Cabrera. And Singy, it's unique these days, but he's more of a pitch-to-contact type of guy.
Yeah, Boogie, he doesn't rely too heavily on the strikeout. He knows he needs to miss barrels, get some soft contact, let the defense do work behind him. And I think a guy like that can keep a good tempo, don't give hitters time to adjust or think. They can move to a ballgame and look off. They're in line for a quality start. We'll see what he's got.
We go to the bottom of the first. Now it's the right fielder, Manuel Margot. Outside part of the plate.
That's where you want. It's a good miss.
Righty delivers. Gonna count one and two.
That was straight queso right there.
One, two to Margot. Bounce to the right side. One up, one down. All right, let's take a look at the Rays lineup. This team, Chris, not one that gets a lot of production from hitting homers, so they've got to find offense in other ways.
Yeah, Boog, hit sequencing is so important for this team. You're getting that walk at the right time, coming up with that next knock or extra base hit so that you can actually play the run. If not, then you see the record go in the direct opposite direction of where it could go. So, you know, a team like this, the good thing, they're going to battle, they're going to put the ball in play, and hope that they can find those holes.
David Peralta takes a strike there as he stands at the plate now. The 0-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The wind of the pitch. The other way, has some trouble with it. No throw, he's in safely, and now there's a runner at first.
Batting first. Shortstop.
Now batting Wander Franco. First offering and it just misses. Back. kicks and deals. And a count one and two. Oh, that one rides up and in.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Next offering misses, and a full countdown.
Tough take right there. He swings at that more often than not.
Next pitch is popped up. And he makes the catch. And there's two away.
Going to have a little more discipline in future at bats. That pitch looked good, but you can't hit it. It was just too high in the zone. You usually see a swing and miss or weak contact in the infield.
Wow, at the plate. First offering misses the mark. Upstairs.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
The pitch. That one fouled off, 2-2. Peralta off of first with two away. Back.
He's getting the barrel to the ball. He's just got to work on that timing a little bit.
And the pitch. Now, that is the inning. We head to the second here at Tropicana Field. No score. Luis Arraez stands in.
This splits between April and May there.
The Marlins, the second baseman, Luis Arraez.
Springs back to work. Good eye right there.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
A wind of the pitch. There's a strike. Ed Drummond behind the plate calling balls and strikes. Maybe one of the most respected umpires around the league.
He's not the kind of umpire that you're likely to notice back there. And that could be a huge compliment, really. So if you're just kind of quietly doing your job, staying consistent with your calls, hitters, pitchers, managers, even fans, they're all going to appreciate you. Ed Drummond, he's that kind of umpire.
And there's one down. How much were you aware of the umpire scouting report, or even who was going to be umpiring?
Not a whole lot. I mean, there were a couple of umpires that weren't real good, but outside of that, you just kind of went into the game, especially back when I was playing.
So here's Brown at the plate. Put that 600 slugging into context. The league average usually in the low 400s. That one's in there, 0-1. As the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in clubhouses where they have pictures of all four guys, nicknames, hometowns, and as well hobbies listed, just so you can kind of small talk the umpire a little bit.
That's great.
Left-hand hitter waits. Stays alive. No score here in the second. Swings and misses. Two down.
Nice. Doubled up with the slider for that punch out. The 1-4 just caught the zone. So as a hitter, you have to protect right there. Great pitch to just expand a little bit more. He got that chase he was looking for. That right there is good pitching.
Two outs, base is empty. And here's the first baseman, Lewin Diaz. Pitch misses inside, and it's 1-0. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And that one wrapped foul. Second inning here, no score. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. Here comes the pitch. On the ground to third. And no throw. He's in the first easily.
Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Once in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Now, here is Adolis Garcia. Good power, not great in the OBP department. And first offering is fouled off. Good eye right there. And now lefty swings and lines a base hit into left field. So that's two straight two-out hits.
Back-to-back singles. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front, nipped into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ball game.
Jacob Stallings now. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. First and second, two down. Next pitch inside, and that's ball one. And he deals. And delivers outside.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
Two outs. Swing and a miss. That is strike two. Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. In the air, left field. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And the inning is over. Marlins strand the pair. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the inning. Now up for Tampa Bay, G-Man Choi.
The first baseman, G-Man Choi.
And a pitch. And it's fouled away. The pitch. On the ground to the left. Tosses to first. And a quick out number one.
Batting six. The third baseman.
Isaac Paredes now. In there for strike one. Nothing here in the bottom of the second. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. And fouled off. the wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and there's two away.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically, he likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, little legs.
Designated hitter, Jeff Pinter.
And now, Jeff Pinter. This to center field, Chisholm settles underneath it, makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Nothing to do it for Tampa. We'll move to the third with no score. Welcome back, digging in, Jazz Chisholm. Singing, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. First pitch, not close.
And I would say that most great defensive outfielders, it's kind of natural. There is some work that you can do to it to improve your game. But ultimately, you either have it or you don't.
Falling behind 2-1. Just missed.
There's one guy that I can think about, Boog, who started as a third baseman, Alex Gordon, and then became an elite perennial Gold Glover out in left field for the Kansas City Royals. But he's a guy, when you watch him play, you would imagine that that's all he ever played in his life was the outfield.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Gene Segura, the next up for the Marlins. To first, and they got him picked off. To second, and it's out. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Well, the key to his success is getting ahead early in the count. He cannot afford to go deep in the counts. Doesn't have a ton of swing and miss stuff, so he's going to have to work efficiently.
Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. This one in the air, center field. A Rosarena should have this one. Puts the squeeze on that one. Two down.
The left fielder, number 24, Ramon Laureano.
Laureano comes up to hit. Now a high fly ball out to left center. A Rosarena settles under this one. And that is the third out of the inning. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Back here at Tropicana Field, and now the switch in at catcher, Francisco Mejia.
The catcher, Francisco Mejia.
Cabrera back to work. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one.
Well, in the no-hole count, not every strike is a good strike for a hitter. I like the plate discipline there.
Left-hand batter waits. That's off the mark. 2-2. Swing and a miss. the velocity blasted it right past him. Now it's Randy Arozarena.
The center fielder, Randy Arozarena.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. And the right-hander deals. Down the line towards the corner. Garcia drifts towards it. Two-way now.
The right fielder, number 13, Manuel.
Manuel Margot up to the plate. First offering misses badly for ball one. And a foul ball. Next offering is in for a strike. And the righty deals. Way high. Two down, nobody on. Fall off foul. Two two. This one smoked out to left. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that will end the inning. Down the order, go the Rays. And we are still scoreless. Back now in Tampa Bay, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton. And set to lead off the fourth, Yoan Moncada.
Yoan.
Kick the pitch. And he flips the breaking ball in there. Or a changeup.
Either one. Something off speed. Good arm action on it. Whatever it was. He's been pitching well, but going through this middle of the order second time through, we'll see what kind of adjustments are being made.
Next offering is foul back. And a pitch. That one misses. And a count, one and two. And a ball evens the count.
Two balls, two strikes.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One away.
That was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. Received more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
And now for the Marlins, Luis Arraez. And that's in there for strike one. One down, base is empty. And it's even up. And there's a ball. And a foul. foul ball. Next offering is foul back. Kicks and fires. Swing and a pop-off in foul ground. And there's two away.
The bat, number 15, designated hitter, Seth.
And up next for Miami, Seth Brown. That one's in there, 0-1.
Well, we call that keyhole. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
Next pitch misses, and it's a ball and a strike. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And the count 1-2. The pitch. Oh, now this is blasted. Way back there, on its way. Gone. Seth Brown goes deep. The Marlins on the board first. It's 1-0.
For a pitcher, the odds are in your favor if you keep that breaking ball down. That time, he got punished for it. Hitter just did a really good job of staying within himself and getting the barrel to the baseball.
Lewin Diaz, the next up for the Marlins. Reached on an infield single his first time.
Lewin Diaz.
Swings through that one, 0-1. And here it comes. And that one got a piece of it.
So, Boog, if you had to take one for the team, where would you want to get hit?
Chris, I think I'd have to say upper hamstring.
Adolis.
And here is Adolis Garcia. And he's already singled in this game. Drill out towards left center field. That's well struck. That's back. On the warning track. Holds it in.
Oh man, amazing catch to end the inning. As a former outfielder, I'm feeling proud right now. Saw the wall, didn't get afraid, held on to the ball. Yeah, you know this me. You can't stop my shine.
I'm just doing me. Yeah, I'm gonna take it. And welcome back. Bottom four, David Peralta at the plate.
Leading up for the Rays, the left fielder.
The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
That's down and in.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
Righty to the plate. And now 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
And there's a foul ball. The first out.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. With all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs
they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate, so very difficult to get the barrel on.
Next offering is in for a strike. Kicks and deals. Just missed. Next offering misses, and the count is 3-1. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's ball four.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted at first base with a quick free pass.
And now it's Brandon Lau. He has, as they like to say, light tower power. Not a big guy, but a big swing. And thunder in that bat. Next pitch downstairs. 1-0. Righty delivers, and another ball.
Probably looks more focused at the plate and working the count after that first at-bat strikeout.
The Rays hitless so far in the game. Next one misses, and that's ball three.
Looks like he's still trying to find a consistent release point in that curveball. That one just sort of popped out of his hand. No real command and finish to it. It's going to be real important for him to finish that pitch, throw it down in the zone where he wants to, if it's going to be effective for him throughout this game.
And he deals. Downstairs and misses ball four.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
And now the hitter, G-Man Choi.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
You know, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
Next offering misses. Ball one.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
Tying run in scoring position as the Rays try and punch back down the run. Next offering is downstairs. At the belt and fires. And it's filled up. Pulls that one foul. Foul off again. And it remains 3-2. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Season, and they lead it. It's 3-1. He kept swinging, and it paid off.
Well, that was a battle, Boog, and he just kept taking his cuts, finally squared one up. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So up next, Isaac Paredes. 0-for-1, he struck out swinging last time. Out to short. Toss to Diaz, and he's out.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Chad Pinder.
Chad Pinder now. And the first offering is not close. Here comes a pitch. Now this is in the air down the line. Makes a nice grab and a full sprint. And that'll do it. Three-run bomb for Tampa Bay. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Back here at the ballpark, new inning getting started. And at the plate for Miami, Jacob Stallings. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. When you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. And there's the strike.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position. And that's what he does.
And now the lefty, foul ball. Oh, and two now. And a swing and a miss. Well, there's one away.
Well, that was a really good job setting him up right there. Pitcher and catcher working together to finish him off. Fastball, and even though the location probably wasn't what he wanted, the sequence is what got the job done. Clearly late with the swing after seeing the off-speed stuff on the pitch before.
Jazz Chisholm now. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
The hitting's going to come around. He's going to figure it out. But right now, his big asset is the way he plays the game on defense.
And the pitch. Check swing, and he held up. Left-hand hitter waits. There's the strike.
In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection to go with.
Kicks and fires. Fouls one off. 2-2. Filled up 3-2. Now fly ball to right center. A Rosarena gliding to his left. Makes the grab on the run. That's out number two.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first, and that's going to be ruled a swing. 0-1 now.
You want to be patient here. Try to work a walk if you can. You've got a big power bat behind you in the on-deck circle. And with two outs, one swing puts you right back in this ballgame.
Not close with that one, and it's 2-1. That's inside.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
And he grounds one to the right side. throw over to Choi. Segura out in the play. And the inning is over. And the Marlins down quietly. Score holds. It's 3-1. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for the Rays, Francisco Mejia.
The catcher, Francisco Mejia.
The pitch. A swing and a miss, and that's strike one. Signs of activity in the pen for the Marlins. Lucas Litke appears to be warming for Don Mattingly. Blyer getting cranked up as well. The pitch. That one off the mark, and that's ball two. Hit weakly on the ground. On the run, throw to first. In there safely.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw. You know?
Yeah, no question.
And now, Randy Arozarena. He's 0-1. Next offering is down low. And that's ball one. And the right-hander deals. And he chases a high fastball there.
The baseball's coming out of his hand very well. He's been able to paint all four corners, but really good ride at the top of the zone. Hitters have to respect that. Very difficult pitch to hit.
Runner at first with no outs here. That one fouled off, 2-2. And a pitch. Swing and a line drive. Base hit out of the center field. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
He needed that one. It's been a tough stretch at the plate lately. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Now the Marlins manager out of the dugout, and he'll make a move to the pen. Edward Cabrera is done, and the line not closed on him yet as he's responsible for the runners on base. Back with a new pitcher after this. So the Marlins go with a new arm, Yuri Perez. He's pitching on 2 days rest.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he made a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
So the lineup flips over. Here's Manuel Margot. Lifted in the air, right center field. Chisholm on the move to the alley. Long run, tracks it down. Runner tags up for third, and he moves up 90 feet. Runners at the corners now, one away.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the left fielder,
So digging in, David Peralta. So RBI spot, but Chris, this is a guy that is not really swinging the bat all that well here.
In this situation, you have a real good opportunity to get swings and misses and record a strikeout. I think you attack him in this spot. Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, or maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable. This is a situation where the hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can get his arms extended. What you have to be careful of is that pitch that's up, that's in on your hands. That'll pop you up in the infield, and that's exactly what the pitcher wants.
And here it comes. Now one miss. And a pitch. And that'll load the bases.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, too. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Here's Wander Franco.
Well, he's so good about trying to drive the ball to the opposite field gap in these situations. If he takes that approach, he could bust this game wide open.
First pitch just misses. Mejia at third. Arozarena on second. Peralta over at first with one away. Fouled off left side. Lifted in the air. Franco gone on the play. Runner tags from third. The tag, and that's out number three in and over. So the Rays strand the pair, but they still lead it 3-1. Sixth inning. And now for the Marlins, Ramon Laureano. The pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Moving into the bullpen, Andrew Kittredge. Getting ready to go. One now. And now the count. One and two after the swing and the miss.
Here we go, Ray.
The 1-2. Misses just off the outside edge. I think that was a strike. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And one away.
Been a pretty rough start to this series for him at the plate. Three strikeouts in the first game yesterday. Another one right there. They've clearly got a great plan for how to deal with this guy right now.
And now Yoan Moncada. First pitch, not close. Deals. And now 2-0. The pitch. He swings and fouls one off. The 2-1. And a foul ball. That one pushed to the left and foul. Right into the plate. Up the middle. And there's a hit. So Atlanta aboard now with one away.
Well, the last 10 games or so have been anything but fun at the plate for him, so that one has to feel good.
Just kept it simple, played Pepper with the middle of the infield, and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Man at first with one gone, and up next for Miami, Luis Arraez. Way inside, and that hit him.
That's a scary one when it's riding up above the ladders. Looked to me like he just tried to overthrow the fastball a little bit.
Ryan Yarbrough takes over on the mound, trying to protect this lead.
Your attention, please. Now pitching to the play.
So now here's the DH, Seth Brown.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
First offering misses the mark.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
The 1-0. And the 1-0 misses low. And it's just foul. That's close. Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even.
Really good cutter that he's able to front door and back door. That pitch is devastating.
Runners at first and second with one gone. Stays alive. Left-hand batter waits. Hit hard, that gets through. Headed for the plate. The throw home. Tag, not in time, safe. And they trail by one. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the bat.
And now the first baseman, Lewin Diaz. First offering, and it just misses. One out. Runners at first and second. Two on, one out.
It becomes pretty difficult as a teammate when a guy's struggling like this. You don't know if you want to go up and tell him to keep swinging it or give him his space, what exactly he needs. But right now, it's clearly a struggle for him. And we're just hoping that somehow, some way, it'll click and he can get out of this as quickly as possible.
So first and second with two outs. And now the right fielder, Adolis Garcia. Kicks and deals.
Nope.
That one pulled foul. Two outs. Strike three, shot of swinging. Good job and damage control right there. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's now a 3-2 ball game. Back here at Tropicana Field, standing in is the power hitting second baseman, Brandon Lau. Harris, back to work. There's a strike. The wind of the pitch.
Ball one.
And a foul ball left side. Up the middle, out to short, Segura handles. Not in time, he's safe.
The effort was there with the jump run. You got a lot of it, but it just wasn't in time. Still, really impressive play. Just to get to that ball and make it close at first. And not every shortstop could even make that play.
Now it's going to be G-Man Choi. He really made his presence felt back in the fourth inning of this one, Siggy.
Absolutely. Three-run blast and a shot of energy for his teammates. Everyone in that dugout was pretty fired up.
Throw to first. Lau back in on a dive. There and it's 0-1. And a pitch. Way out front for strike two.
Well, that's textbook pitching right there. I mean, he executed those first two pitches perfectly.
The next pitch misses. Now 1-2. Lau on at first. Nobody out. Next pitch in the dirt. Two balls, two strikes. Right-hander kicks, deals. And that just misses.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike if he swings her.
And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. One away, bottom of the sixth. Now the third base, Isaac Perez. First offering misses badly for ball one. That catches the corner.
One and one.
The 1-1. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. Slapped foul. And he deals. Stays alive. One run game, one out, one on. That one not close. Now 2-2. Righty delivers. That one foul off. Two down. a foul ball. He stays alive.
Now he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Line drive. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there are two down.
The bat, the designated hitter, Chad.
And at first, next is the designated hitter, Chad Pinder. And the first offering is not close.
Clearly didn't come out of his hand the right way. Left that curveball way up.
And the 1-0. Misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. Right-handed reliever. That just missed. He walked him on four pitches.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner in the scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
Francisco Mejia coming up to hit. There's a swing and a drive. That's bad. It bangs off the wall. One run is in. Now two runs score, and they lead by three. And he's got a two-run triple.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Just missed out on a home run right there, but he certainly hit it hard enough. Just didn't have the right launch angle to carry it over the wall, but still an excellent swing of the bat.
Runner at third, two gone. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Randy Arozarena, one for two.
Randy.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. And that one lifted in the air, center field. Chisholm makes the catch, and that'll do it. So they pick up a pair here, both coming on this two-run triple. It's 5-2. Top of inning number seven, and now the catcher comes up to him, Jacob Stallings.
The
fish in striking distance, but has some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
The line of the pitch. And takes low for ball one. The line of the pitch. Foul ball there. And now the lefty. Slow roller to third. Tosses across to first. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
The center fielder, number two, Jazz Chisholm.
And now the center fielder, Jazz Chisholm. He's 0 for 1. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Pitch. The punch out there, and there's two down.
Well, I'm not sure what he was waiting on right there. He got the changeup and still laid on it. You rarely see that. It almost makes you think that he was trying to set the pitcher up. I mean, if you can't catch up to the off-speed stuff, no way you're going to touch a fastball.
Two outs, bases empty. Gene Segura, the next up for the Marlins. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
And what makes him even quicker is the fact that he's so dialed in on the pitch as it's moving through the hitting zone. He can see how that hitter's lined up, what he's trying to do, and where that pitch is going to end up, which gives him that really quick first step. And that's why he makes so many great plays.
Next offering is in for a strike. Two down, nobody on. Ground ball right side. The throw to first. Segura out in the play. That's the third out. And 1-2-3 go the Marlins. And the deficit remains 5-2. Your pitcher for the Marlins, Lucas Litke. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Back now in Tampa Bay. Now it's the right fielder, Manuel Margot.
Leading off for the Rays, the right fielder, Manuel Margot.
Pitch. Ball one there. At the belt and fires. Oh, that ball got him pretty good out there on the mound. And he's safe at first. Now the left fielder, David Peralta, for the fourth time tonight. In there for strike one. Margot gets his lead at first with nobody out. Next pitch misses, and one and one. Meanwhile, activity of the bullpen. Tyler Matzik, the left-hander, up and throwing. Moved first, and he's back in easily. And the pitch. Grounder might be two. There's one. Over to Diaz. Double play.
No matter. Number five. Just up.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Wander Franco. First pitch just misses. And here it comes. And now it's even up.
One and one.
Kicks and fires. That clips the corner.
Let's go. Wait for the pitch.
Good eye in that spot.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Next pitch is outside. Kicks and deals. Garcia glides back. Great catch, foul ground up against the wall. Yeah. Anderson in, and he'll work on holding this lead.
Number 76, Anderson.
Ready to begin the eighth. Now, here is Ramon Laureano.
Leading off for the Marlins.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats, trying to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth, that closer's coming in.
There's the strike. There's the swing and a miss.
Another 0-2 count right here. Pitcher just in the driver's seat. He can go anywhere he wants to go right here.
Anderson ready to work. Way high. Next offering is in the dirt. And a pitch. Cut on and missed. Struck him out. And one gone.
Well, that's a curveball that I'm sure he wants back at the plate. Two strikes, sort of pitch you're hoping for, a bit of a mistake, and I'd say in a very hittable location, but clearly the break was enough to get him to swing through it.
Yoan Moncada, the next up for the Marlins. 1-3. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Right-hander kicks, deals. Two balls, no strikes to count.
Two balls, no strikes.
High in the air, out to right. Margot on his way over, squeezes it. Two up, two down.
The batter number 3, second baseman, Luis Arraez.
Two outs, base is empty. And at the plate for Miami, Luis Arraez. Swings through that one, 0-1.
This guy's usually not one to chase pitches off the plate, but he did there. We'll see if he can tighten up his zone a little bit.
Here comes a pitch. Just missed.
Just missed with that backdoor breaking ball. If he gets a swing and miss or called strike, 0-2 count. Instead, it's 1-1. Look for him to go back to that pitch later in this at-bat.
So, a foul ball makes it 1-2.
All right, Rich.
The pitch. Downstairs. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velocity.
Good battle here, about to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. And he walked him.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Brooks Raley comes on now. He last pitched 4 days ago, so he should feel pretty fresh. At the plate, Seth Brown. He's already homered here in this one. And that's in there for strike one. The pitch. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Left-hand hitter waits. And that one fouled off. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. That's out number three. Marlins leave one. They trail at 5-2. So I ain't saving you a cleaning house. Welcome back. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Now it's the second baseman, Brandon Lau.
For the Reds, the second baseman, Brandon Lau.
And the pitch. There's a strike.
0-1.
And down on strikes he goes. One out.
Well, that pitch wasn't even close to being a strike, and that just goes to show you how defensive hitters can become when they're up against an 0-2 count. You're just hoping for a mistake somewhere near the zone that you can get the bat to, but right there, he was clearly anxious. He was swinging when the ball left the hand.
And the batter now, G-Man Choi. That one's in there, 0-1. And a pitch. Nope. Now 1-1. That one missing inside.
Come on now,
the pitch. Center field, Chisholm moving under it and puts the squeeze on that one. Out number two.
Now batting, the third baseman,
Isaac Paredes, now at the plate. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. There's a strike.
Throwing the ball well, and they need this scoreless inning in relief right here. Been doing a good job keeping him in striking distance.
And now the lefty. Line drive. That's a base hit out of the left center field. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. And he's in there standing up with a two-out double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but he'll take that swing and that result every time.
At the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Chad Pinder.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Chad.
Out towards right center field, Garcia on the move, brings it in with a nice running grab. And that is that. One left for Tampa. They're still out front 5-2. back here at the ballpark, all set to start the ninth in this one. And now for the Marlins, Lewin Diaz.
The first baseman, Lewin Diaz.
The pitch. A bit behind with that swing. It's strike one. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss. And it's 0-2. And a pitch. And down on strikes. One gone here.
Well, I definitely say that's a statement strikeout right there. You come out of the bullpen, go right after the hitters, and three pitches later, you got one out. I'll tell you what, if you're in the dugout, you're looking at each other and saying, he's going to be tough to get to today.
Adolis Garcia, the next up for the Marlins. First pitch is in the dirt. Here it comes. Fastball almost got him there.
Not showing great command so far in this at bat. 2-0 count. He's got to execute here or this could get ugly.
Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
2-1 now. On the ground is short. Franco picks it up, slings it across, and Garcia is out.
Now batting, catcher Jacob Stallman.
And now it's going to be Jacob Stallman. He is at the top of the game in terms of defense at the catching spot. That one ripped, but foul.
It's so impressive because these guys have to do so much study and preparation for their pitchers, for opposing hitters, and really their number one job is to guide that staff through a ball game. And so when you also can turn it up offensively and be a force there, that is a win-win, every manager's dream.
Two down, nobody on. That one misses, and a count 2-1. Two outs. There's a strike. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
Two and two. And that one just missed off the outside edge. And he deals. Swing and a bouncer, and he grabs it in foul ground. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I'll tell you what, he earned that walk.
Back to the top of the lineup, Jazz Chisholm, the next up for the Marlins. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Kicks and deals. Throw the first, ball game, and the Rays get out of here with a split in this brief two-game series.
Well, someone from the bullpen had to come in, get a big out. And they had a little time to think about it before they went back out to get the final three outs of this ballgame. Nonetheless, outstanding job to get the save and secure the win for this team.
And your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Just shots never hit. I'm just graduating. I've been up in the cap. No cap. Give me the passion for the map. Who the map? I've been around the world and I got you with that. Now move it back. B.I.G. by Function of Mission. Do my IV designated. People in the NPMs up in every yellow diamond in the pinky. My kids are keeping so exquisite. Roll official. I'll be on the mission.